And Joey West is invited out of the faceoff circle, but Carleton emerges with the puck nonetheless. And a shot on now. A great blocker save from DeVie. After a good look from Charles Correa just outside of the slot. RMC now working from behind their own net. The clearing effort can't quite do it. Picked up by Carleton, and now that one will squirt behind the net. That's Joe Placatus who's giving pressure down low. Picked up by Jordan Deagle on the pinch. Around the net for Placatus, who couldn't quite handle it, and Charles Correa couldn't quite keep it in. Carleton will regroup as they work back into their defensive zone. That's Joey West who will feed his teammate in the neutral zone, but Joe Placatus couldn't quite get it in deep. Carleton will get a change as RMC fumbles a little bit there in their own zone. That one's deflected in as now RMC will get a change, and Carleton will look to break out. Tim Billingsley now hits his winger. Oh, but that one's picked up now by Paul Fone, who looks to dump it in. A little too far for his teammate there. As Carleton looks to break out and just get it over the blue line, but can't quite get it deep. A little back and forth puck exchange now, as no one can really seem to generate an opportunity or even some real puck movement now, as that one's caught up against the boards just outside the Carleton blue line, ultimately knocked in and now back out. That's going to be Mike Lowry bringing it in on the far wing. He shoots that one in wide as DeVie just offers at it. A centering effort, but nobody there. That's RMC breaking out. Dumped in deep by Anthony Farrow as Brad Albert now. A diving effort there from the RMC defender, but Brad Albert manages to get it in deep. Keeps it in with his glove there. And then hits the deck after
penalty coming out.
Well, indeed, he must have had the legs taken out from under him, because, as Mike aptly noted, we will get a penalty.
Carlton's power play will go to work for the first time tonight. They've been looked really good as of late, usually going with four forwards and one D. We'll see what they do here.
Well, how important has been the return of Joey Manley to this power play unit?
Him anchoring that blue line, as the stats are, they've gone way up since he rejoined the team. I believe he's averaged close to a point per game since his return.
In fact, more than that, he's got four just in his last two contests alone, and he's really been a stabilizing force along that blue line, particularly on this power play for Carleton.
Yes, this power play is looking more and more lethal with every game that goes by.
Jeff Hayes wins that draw cleanly. That's going to be Billingsley for Manley. Manley hits Jeff Hayes. Hayes along the half boards. Down low now, that's going to be Berard, who centers for Billingsley, and a shot on, but that one didn't quite reach that. Another shot on as that one goes wide, and now Berard at the doorstep, and that's a loose puck in the crease, and DeVie just gets over there and swats it away with his pad, but RMC finally manages to get it out after a couple of nice opportunities there for the Ravens. And just 32 seconds into the Carleton power play, we'll have that man advantage negated as Tim Billingsley takes what I believe was a cross-checking penalty.
It was indeed. He got beat there. Puck was outside the zone, and he had no other choice. Weston, Placatus, Albert, and Stannis out there for Ravens on this 4-on-4 opportunity.
That draw is won by Joey West. He gets it back down for Stannis, who will send for Albert. Albert for Placatus. Sends it to Stannis. Stannis stood up there by Bouchard, and I believe we have an offside call. Brandon McLean wins that draw back to Filiatro, and he'll look to break out. And now it's for McLean, who can't quite handle it, and Carleton will pick it up in the neutral zone. Stannis fans on the first effort, and on the second effort gets it to Joe Placatus, who will break in. Placatus dances around his move, and a centering effort, and a shot on there from Joey West as he fired it just over the net, but a golden opportunity there after a gorgeous centering effort from Joe Placatus.
What an inside-outside move there by Placatus, and getting the puck over to West. West would like that one back.
Now a shot, and he scores! Matthew Stannis works his way into the slot and fires a nice low wrister that DeVie just couldn't get a piece of.
Yeah, Ravens won a puck battle along the boards and were able to funnel to the center of the ice, where Stannis was able to beat him for a little ways out.
And for Stannis, who has 9 helpers on the season, that'll be his first, as the kids say, Gino of the campaign, and perhaps a monkey off his back, as I bet He was waiting for that one a long time coming.
Absolutely. He looks pretty fired up now.
And now with just about 10 minutes into the first period, Carleton will take their first lead of the contest as Standish, the goal scorer, is now pinned along the boards. And there we get confirmation that it was indeed Matthew Standish who fired that one past DeVie. And now it's Carleton who will look to add to that lead. That's going to be Berard breaking it in with Manley. Berard from an awkward angle off the skate of DeVie, but perhaps a little more challenging than it should have been. Now it's Pinder now breaking in. Pinder from an awkward angle. That one's gloved easily by Ryan Dubé. And we'll get a whistle.
32 seconds of power play time coming up for RMC. They're going to send out their number one unit and try and get that goal right back.
And indeed, as the penalties RMC expires, that one is promptly fired into the RMC bench, and we'll get another whistle down in the Carleton zone as that first Paladin unit remains on the ice. That draws one by RMC. Colin O'Rourke now gets it down deep. Sent back out to the blue line, and Pinder can't quite keep it in. That's O'Rourke now who will look to set something up. Now it's Pinder. Along the half boards now, that's Brandon Casper. On the blue line for Pinder, a shot on. Easily steered aside by Ryan Dubé. Not a whole lot of mustard on that effort as the penalty expires and we're back to even strength. Behind the net now, that one's going to be picked up by Jordan Deagle. Nice pass for Jeff Hayes, who will bring it in with a little bit of speed. Hayes can't quite get around his man, and that one's picked up by RMC and fired out of harm's way. 8:36 to go in this opening frame here this evening as Lyndon Boehm tries to work out of his own zone, but there's pressure on, and he deftly eludes that checker. Fired in now by Carleton. To the blue line for Folks. Folks with a shot on. That one doesn't quite reach the net. Picked up by Folks again. He'll fire across for Standish. It's going to be Shane Baker who sends it across to Lyndon Boehm. That centering effort ends up on the wing for Standish. Standish gets it down low for Baker, who tries to dance his way around for two men. Back to Baker. Behind the net for Boehm. Boehm walking out in front. A shot on from a difficult angle. That one stopped by DeVie. To the blue line now for Folks. He gets that one down deep, and it's Joey Manley who will give chase, but couldn't quite corral the puck as RMC still can't get it out. And now that's Joey Manley who gets tied up with an RMC defender, but the Paladins prevail. That's Touin who will dump it in deep, and RMC will get a change. Now Folks will send it in, and his forwards, that's Mike Lowry who will give chase. RMC goaltender sends it across for his teammates, but they couldn't retain possession. Behind the net now, Mike Lowry hammers his man into the boards. And kept in by Carleton. Intercepted along the half boards, and Carleton will keep it in. Brad Albert now with a shot on. That one's fired wide. Picked up behind the net by Carleton, but they couldn't quite hold on to it. A little bit too slippery as that one's out into the neutral zone, and we're going to have a high stick call as that was Brandon McLean, whose wood was a little bit too high.
Two great back-to-back shifts right there by Carleton. They're establishing their cycle early in this one and funneling the pucks to the front of the net.
.646 to go here in the first period. Carleton out shooting RMC 8-5. As that one is sent into the Paladin zone. It's going to be Eric Bouchard who tries to break out. Now along the wing for Colin Cook. Cook now working around his man Brad Albert. Tries to center in front, but I believe that one's off a skate and back into the corner. Brad Albert working behind his net with his defensive partner Tim Billingsley, who's going to break out. Now for Joey West. Centers for Ryan McLean. Oh, just a little bit out of his reach as McLean could have had an opportunity there. Carlton retains possession, though. That's Brad Albert. Shot on. That one's deflected off of Braden Casper and just to the right of the RMC netminder. RMC chips that one out, but Carlton will pick it up and look to pounce again. A far shot on. That one's whistled wide of the net by Tim Billingsley. Kept in there by the glove of Charles Correa, but we're going to have a whistle due to a hand pass.
Hand pass, right, JR. First line minutes back out there for the Ravens. And it's Pim and McDonald coming out for the RMC.
This has indeed been a potent first unit for the Ravens so far this season, and I believe a lot of that can be attributed to the sensational puck-moving abilities of Jeff Hayes and the finishing ability of Mitch Borowski.
Right, you are. Hayes, with speed through the neutral zone, is able to hit Borowski driving to the net. We've seen that goal time and time again this year.
And he might be a little guy, but he's actually tied for the team lead in penalty minutes. He is very shifty indeed. RMC now breaking out of their own zone as that attempt at the stretch pass didn't quite work as I believe that was Touin who got tied up in the neutral zone and, Quinlan who hit the deck there. Sent in by RMC as Charles Correa pursues. Sends it for Jordan Deagle who is shoved there into the boards by Farrow. Now Carlton break into the RMC zone. That's Jeff Hayes. Jeff Hayes tries to center in front. I'm not sure DeVa knows where it is, but ultimately, no damage done as it was just caught up in his pads.
Exhibit A right there from Jeff Hayes. Speed to the neutral zone and taking the puck wide to the front of the net.
He must have heard us. He's got moves like Jagger, you might even say. RMC will emerge with the puck following that draw. And they get it just outside of their own blue line, but... And now they'll regroup inside their own zone and look to break out. Can't quite get the dump in deep there, as Carlton will send it back in, but it's picked up by RMC. Oh, and a fan on the clearing effort there by McDonald as Carlton picks it up in the offensive zone. That's going to be Shane Baker, who sends it for Matthew Standish. Standish from the blue line. He bluffs, sends it to Baker. Baker with a shot on! But that one is right into the breadbasket of DeVa.
With 4:33 to go in the first period, we can see a bit of an extra jump in the step of Shane Baker. He sure is relishing that role back up on the second line after being demoted as more of an energy player on the fourth line for the first half of the year.
Well, he's a bit of an enigma, I have to say, because on some days he looks like he has really impeccable puck-moving abilities and really quite an impressive offensive flair, but other days he just looks like an energy guy.
I agree. I think we're going to start to see a lot more consistency out of him. He's starting to come around.
And we have a whistle there. Not too sure what for, but they'll continue to play that funky music nonetheless. That draws one back by RMC, and they'll look to break out as, oh, they hit the deck on the clearing effort, and Carlton will send that one in deep and give chase.
Lowry may have been banged up on his last shift. I see Jeff Hayes out there at the fourth line.
And we'll keep you updated as to his status as Binning gets out on the action. And he fires that one in on DeVa, and it's gloved without too much effort.
He may see a lot of rubber tonight. The Ravens are throwing everything they got towards the net.
And despite his record, he's actually performed quite admirably this year. He's got a 920 save, or pardon me, that's their starting goaltender, but I'm
mixing. They got Ottawa U tomorrow. I think they're saving him for tomorrow.
Indeed they are. I'm mixing up my netminders here as that one skips over the stick of Billingsley, but Carlton will pick it up and look to break out. Oh, and Joey West is hammered there by Touin. He didn't see him coming, and he shoved him to the ice. That's Brad Albert now, who will chip that one in for his teammates, and Ryan McLean will give chase. Played by DeVia, he'll send it up and along the boards as RMC breaks out. Picked up in the neutral zone by Joe Placatus. Placatus fires that one on, but it is off the leg of Scott McDonald and into the netting, and we'll get a whistle. Well, after a slow start, it looks like it's been all Carleton here the past 5 minutes. It looks like that goal for Matthew Standish might have taken a little bit of the wind out of the sails of RMC.
Yeah, and it lit a fire under Carleton. Another great look there for Placatus. Just couldn't get it past the defender.
In the corner now, Hayes sends it in deep, and a bunch of troops will whack at it. That's going to be picked up by RMC, and they'll look to break out. That's Scott Domenico. And a shot on as that one is gloved by Ryan Dubé, but it looks like we have a RMC forward, I believe, or rather defenseman. That looks like Patrick Pinder, who's in a considerable amount of pain.
Yeah, a stick came up and got him in the face. Looks like it went unnoticed by the ref, though. We'll see if the linesman caught it.
And it looks like we have a streak of red following Pinder, so clearly some blood on the ice as he was quick to dispatch himself of his gloves, his mouth guard, and his stick. And he's being tended to.
Quite a bit of red out there now. You got the Carleton Ravens in their red zone versus Red Nation of RMC tonight. Carlton's going to get away with one. Or are they?
Looks like there's a bit of debate as to what the situation is, and perhaps we're going to see Charles Correa. Yeah, indeed, and he will sit for four now.
Yeah, an unfortunate incident there. He was just trying to get under the stick and lift it, but the stick rode up into his face, and the linesman had to make the call on that one as the head official missed it. Well, a goal here for RMC with 2:57 to go before the intermission would be huge.
Well, this could certainly precipitate a change in momentum. And just one particularly interesting thing that I've noticed here is that we have two RMC forwards wearing full cages. And frankly, those are not too common in the OUA.
They sure aren't. Never know if it's an injury thing. Maybe they're worried about high sticks riding up and getting them in the face.
Well, there you go. That's going to be Brandon McLean who wins that draw, and it's ultimately tied up along the far board there. Number of players digging at it, but we will get a whistle as no one was able to successfully extricate the puck. That draw is won by Brandon McLean. Now it's going to be McDonald who sends it up for Bouchard, who will get it in deep. That one's picked up and chipped out by Jeffrey Hayes, but corralled by Alex Pym, who tries for the long stretch pass, and it is RMC who in fact comes away with it, but after some nice physical work by Tim Billingsley, couldn't generate an opportunity. Brandon McLean now with Ryan Berard on his tail. RMC still can't break in. That's going to be Scott McDonald now, who's hammered into the boards by Brad Albert, but they managed to get the puck in deep. That's Bouchard. Couldn't quite hit a teammate, and that one is easily disposed of by Brad Albert, who gets it down the length of the ice, and just about a minute 58 to go here in this first period. Alex Pym now dances away from the attacking Shane Baker as it's the other Pinder, Brett Pinder now, who looks to generate something as they battle in the corner. And Carleton wins that battle, and they'll get it down, and it's Shane Baker now with a nice look and a centering effort, albeit behind the back, and that was picked up by
heads up
Carleton, and a huge hit there behind the net. That was Lyndon Boehm, who was on the receiving end of a rather thunderous hit.
Offside.
Now RMC looking to break in, but we'll have an offside call.
It's amazing. The Ravens use close to 75% of their forwards on the penalty kill. You don't see that from any teams. Usually it's just a top four unit that rotates in and out.
1:16 to go in the opening frame. Carleton with a 1-0 lead. As RMC can't quite get control of it, finally they manage to settle down, and they will look to even the score up here and ideally head into the second period with a game tied at 1-1. Behind the net now, that's going to be Ryan McLean, who's battling with the RMC defenders. That one's picked up by Brett Pinder. He looks to break in, but again, we'll have an offside call as Braden Casper was in there just a second ahead of the play.
The Carleton penalty kill has been effective because of their pressure. They're not conservative. They don't just give up the perimeter. They challenge the players to make a play.
A very aggressive penalty kill indeed, and really RMC but only with 6 shots, and frankly, none of those have really been quality chances. That one is slapped down the length of the ice there by Matthew Stanish, and with 32 seconds to go, RMC will look to generate at least one more rush here. To the neutral zone for Brandon McLean. He brings it in, and again we have an offside call after that one extra move at the blue line.
Yeah, RMC is going to have a minute, just over a minute, to work with the power play on fresh ice, and I'm sure they're going to be making some adjustments. It's 3 offsides already on this power play.
Well, they just don't seem to be on the same page.
Absolutely not.
That one's won by Jeff Hayes. He'll get it back for Tim Billingsley, who will send it down the length of the ice. DeVier's out to play it, but... Oh, he's tad ambivalent there, apparently, as that one gets caught up behind the RMC net. Just 5 seconds to go, as that's Alex Pym trying to break in. Perhaps get one shot off, but ultimately he won't, and... Time will expire as we say goodbye to the first period here, and Carleton clinging to a 1-0 lead, but RMC will have a minute and 3 seconds of power play to go once the second period starts. And what is RMC going to have to do differently to keep themselves in this game in the second period?
They're going to have to establish a forecheck. They haven't been able to do that for the first 20 minutes, and that's something they're going to have to change.
Certainly is, and we'll see you back here in about 18 minutes. Welcome back to the Carleton University Ice House, where the Ravens are holding on to a 1-0 lead over the RMC Paladins, and the Ravens really playing well down the stretch. 7-3 over their last 10, clearly trending in the right direction. RMC, not so much. But tell me, Mike, what would it do for RMC's confidence to emerge with a win here today?
Yeah, you're correct. It really is a tale of two teams going opposite directions. And if RMC can come in here tonight and knock off a red-hot Ravens team, they go to Ottawa U tomorrow. If they can pick up 3 or 4 points this weekend, that would really mean a lot for such a young team.
Young and inexperienced indeed. Only one fifth-year player and one fourth-year player amongst the sea of relatively inexperienced hockey players. And Alex Pym now will adjust his skates as we get set for the second period of action. And remember, RMC will have 1:03 of a man advantage.
Yeah, we'll try and catch on to what adjustments they were able to make against a pretty effective penalty kill that the Ravens brought to the table in the first period.
And here we go, as that's going to be Shane Baker, who is going to head into the faceoff circle with Brandon McLean, and Baker prevails. That's Brad Albert, who will slam that one in, and we are underway here in the second period. Played by DeVia, intercepted by Baker, though. He'll send it back behind the net for Lyndon Boehm. Picked up by RMC. They'll look to break out, and Alex Pym now with a little bit of pressure from Lyndon Boehm. Nice aggressive checking effort there as Brandon McLean now with it. He has his stick lifted by Shane Baker. Kept in. Oh, spoke too soon. That one is fanned on. And now it's going to be Carleton. That's Lyndon Boehm coming in all alone with a nice move and a sensational save from DeVia. Oh, he sprawled and stuck out his left pad and absolutely took one away from Lyndon Boehm.
Really was a great move and even better save. And here comes RMC back the other way.
If I was so inclined, that would probably call for a holy Mackinac.
Well, hopefully for RMC, it just gets the momentum back their way.
And that penalty to Charles Correa will expire as Carleton now tries to center. Nobody there, though. Picked up by Porowski. His shot is smothered before it reaches the net, and now it's back behind the cage for Ryan Berard. Berard sends it to the blue line for Jordan Deagle. Across for Folks. Folks, shot on. That one is steered aside by DeVia. Picked up again by Carleton. Sent around the net for Ryan Berard. Down low for Jeff Hayes, who just squirts away from a check there. Centered. And a shot on for Ryan Berard. Easily knocked aside by DeVia. Porowski now. And tries to finagle a nice little drop pass for his teammate, but picked up by RMC and fired out of play, so we'll get a whistle.
Flawless puck movement there by Carleton. That's the stuff coaches dream of. You can't teach that kind of play. And they generated a couple of good looks at the net out of it.
That one is won by the Paladins. Sent around, and now we'll get a little battle in the corner, but nudged out by RMC, and Charles Correa will give chase with Thouin in hot pursuit. Carleton now breaking out, though. That's Placatus. Gets it in deep, and DeVia is going to opt to glove that one. And
he doesn't want Carleton setting up along the boards in their zone again.
Well, he's certainly clued into how that offense operates, and he didn't want to give him an opportunity to get that puck down in low and let their forecheckers go to work, as that draw is won cleanly by Carleton, but little I got you take it action and they can't keep it in. Dumped in now. DeVia out to play it. Oh, he fans on that one. Second effort, manages to nudge it to the half boards, but it's batted into the corner now. That's going to be Joey West, who sends it for Placatus. Placatus coming out in front from an impossible angle, and it scores! Oh, from a nearly impossible angle! Joe Placatus just fired a shot on net, and DeVia made an awkward effort at it, and it managed to squirt through his pads, and just like that, Carleton with a 2-0 lead.
It really is the old adage, isn't it? Put the puck on net, and good things will happen. We just saw it right there.
Well, if you're the Paladins, that is about the last thing you wanted to happen, especially after such a strong effort from DeVia in the first period and in the couple opening minutes of the second frame here. But that was just a tough one to swallow, and we'll see how RMC comes back now as they win that draw. Alex Pym sends it in deep, and It'll be picked up now in the corner, but Carleton can't get it out. Pym from the blue line tries to get a shot on that one. Deflects off a stick and into the corner. A shot on. That one's deflected. Loose puck now. Behind the net. Carleton manages to get it out of their own zone, but...
hand pass. I
believe we had a hand pass there.
Yep. Yeah, Devilliers really did a good job keeping RMC in it in the first period, and that those are the kind of saves you have to make. We'll see how they respond from that.
Well, in my mind, I thought Joe Placatus was just trying to generate a rebound there for one of his teammates setting up in the slot, battling for position, but lo and behold, it ended up a goal.
We mentioned in the first period, they were throwing pucks on net from all angles, and there it was again.
And Tyler Taylor will send that one in deep as Binning gives chase and manages to swat that effort from, or rather that clearing effort from the RMC netminder, and RMC will break out.
Lowry's back out there for the Ravens, which is a good sign.
Indeed, obviously none too worse for the wear. And he goes into his man hard in the corner there as that one is just eked out of the RMC zone, but ultimately sent back in. Loose puck in the RMC zone, picked up by the Paladins. And now they'll look to break out after a nice little chip in there. Ryan Dubé out to play it. That one's intercepted behind his net as he was cut out of position there for a second, but no damage done. Now Carleton working through the neutral zone. That's going to be Binning. Binning now with McLean hot on his tail. Muscles him off the puck, and it's going to be RMC now. Along the half boards, weak clearing effort, but just manages to get over the blue line. Picked up in the neutral zone by the Paladins. That's going to be McLean, who leaves it for Domenico. Domenico, across the blue line, and a shot on now. That one's stopped by Ryan Dubé. Carleton, working out of their own zone and into Paladin territory, but our linesman Yuck will signal an offside call.
Right idea. They're just one step ahead of the play.
And that slap shot there from, I believe it was Bouchard, constitutes RMC's first shot on net of the second period. And we're just about 5 minutes in, and that's their lone offensive effort so far.
They're outshot 48-24 last weekend in Toronto.
And that was intercepted and almost a breakaway there for Alex Farrow, but he couldn't quite get the puck onto his tape, and you know he'll be shaking his head about that one later. Vachon now working through the neutral zone with a bouncing puck. That one's taken off his tape but corralled by RMC. A shot on, that one's fired wide. Alex Pym now with a nice little pinch and a loose puck in front now. A couple whacks at it from RMC, but Ryan Dubé was right there. Now along the half boards, that's going to be Carleton breaking out. We have a 3-on-2, but Porowski couldn't quite do anything with the puck, and they had to retreat, and they'll just dump it in and get a change as Ryan McLean gives chase. And that one is sent down the length of the ice, and we'll have an icing call. And indeed, we've been mentioning the name Brandon McLean a few times, and it's a name that Carleton fans will be familiar with, but not that Brandon McLean.
Much to the disappointment of many of the fans here in the rink. A walking legend around these parts, Brandon McLean.
Indeed, he was their captain for a number of years, and Carleton gets a shot on there, but it's well wide of the net. Centering in front, that's Joe Placatus, who is absolutely hammered coming through the blue ice, but we will have a penalty call as Carleton will head back to the power play as I believe that's Alex Pym, the captain, who's going to sit for a pair.
And just to touch one more point on McLean there, the guy had 40 points in 28 games for Carleton last year, and usually that's a pretty significant loss, but they've had a lot of players step up this year, including Porowski, who will see some power play time on the number one unit coming up here. Already has 19 points on the season.
That draw is won by Carleton as they'll look to set up their power play behind the net now. That's West who sends it for Placatus. Placatus back for West. Little give and go as a shot on there. Placatus had a good opportunity and a nice save by DeVie. Sent around and kept in by Stanish, but nice effort there from Braden Casper to knock it out of the zone. Carleton will look to pounce again. That's Joey West. Sends it across the ice for Brad Albert. He'll send it in deep, and both Bame and West converge. West working out of the corner now. He's looking for a man. Hits Stanish along the blue line. West again now. As Stanish informs him that he had Aurora caught on his tail. It's going to be Placatus. Trying to work around his man. And again, the give-and-go effort. And into the slot and a shot on. That one was stopped by DeVie and just knocked out of the zone as Carleton is really looking to that give-and-go. And so far, it's been pretty effective in getting them opportunities.
Yeah, two great chances already on this power play. We touched on it in the first period. Carleton was aggressive on the penalty kill. RMC sitting back. He's giving up the perimeter, and Carleton's taking advantage of it.
Stanish bluffs on the shot, gets it again. Now it's Manley. Manley down low for Mitchell Porowski. His passing effort is interfered with there as RMC manages to clear the zone. 30 seconds remaining in this power play. Jeff Hayes now for Ryan Berard. Berard looking for a teammate. That's Hayes down low. Hayes comes out in front. As that one is stopped by DeVie, he did a good job to come out and contest Jeffrey Hayes, who was coming through his blue ice with speed, and he's really done a good job to keep RMC in this game.
He did a great job. He's showing that last goal from the tough angle hasn't rattled him one bit.
One more goal here from Carleton, and you have to think that things might get a little bit out of hand.
Right, Jar. Both teams have games coming up tomorrow, though, so coaches are going to want to be careful.
22 ticks remaining in this power play as Joey Manley wins that draw back. It's Billingsley along the blue line with a shot on as that one is just wide. Nice low wrister there from Tim Billingsley as it's into the slot now, but Mitchell Porowski's shot is interfered with as now it's RMC working on a two-on-one, but couldn't quite connect with one another. And as that penalty to Alex Pym expires, Carleton will look to work it out of their own defensive zone. That's Ryan Berard now for Mitchell Porowski. Porowski sends it in deep. Berard gives chase and looked like he tripped over himself and went hard into the boards, and he's slow to get up. Skating rather gingerly now as RMC breaks in. Along the far wing, a nice centering effort there, but nothing on it. And almost a great stretch pass there for Ryan McLean, who was just coming onto the ice, but good defensive effort from RMC to disrupt that play. That's Scott McDonald now, who manages to work himself out of harm's way with two Carleton attackers, and RMC can't connect with each other in the neutral zone. Now back on their heels again as that one's fired into the bench, and a much-needed breather for RMC, who couldn't really look to get anything going there.
Yeah, they're having trouble crossing the red line, but all they got to do is start getting those pucks in behind the Carleton defenders, turn them around, and get in hard on the forecheck.
And really, I think that we at times fail to acknowledge just how formidable the Carleton defensive core is, but guys like Brad Albert and Tim Billingsley, they really do a sensational job keeping teams at bay.
They sure do. They've been in the shooting lanes as well all night.
Taking away the shots is just the name of the game. 11:28 remaining as Jordan Deagle looks to work out from behind his own net. That's Charles Correa now. His pass is interfered with, but Carleton working into the RMC zone. That's Tyler Taylor who gets it in deep, and Alex Pym will send it along the half boards for his man. Now a battle happening in the corner, but the puck squirts out behind the net. And RMC continuing to fail to get the puck out of their own zone as Alex Pym hammers Binning in the corner there. Once again, they can't penetrate the red line, and it's dumped back into their zone. That's Binning. As Tyler Taylor takes a hard hit from Alex Pym, who's really been asserting himself physically on this shift. And now, we got Taylor and Pym going at it. We might have ourselves a kerfuffle. And Pym tries to rip off the helmet of Taylor, and he didn't take too kindly to that. Fortunately, Alex Pym with the full cage on, not too sure what he was expecting to do, but
that doesn't sit too well with many hockey players when you got a guy with a cage challenging a guy with a visor. They're both going to go off and serve some time.
They sure are, and Tyler Taylor makes sure to get his 2 cents in as a little bit of jawing going back and forth. And really, this is the first sign of life we've seen from the Paladins all evening.
That's Alex Bim. He's really made a name for himself in Kingston. He's a second-year player, and they strapped the C on his jersey after playing 1 year junior A there. He's really stepped up, and I think he's been their best player so far tonight.
There's no debating that, and a proud Winnipeg, Manitoba export. Apparently, they play some good hockey down there. I don't know if you can confirm or deny
that. You could say that.
Centering effort now. Shane Baker will opt to send it to the blue line. Now it's Tim Billingsley. Billingsley with a shot on as that one's deflected. But into the chest of DeVie, who gives his head a little shake. Perhaps he didn't see that till the last second, but did a good job to come out and cut off the angle. And
That save comes to be a lot harder when it's coming through traffic and he can't pick it up off the shooter's stick.
And that's one thing the Carleton forwards do so well, is generating traffic in front of opposing netminders.
And Tim Billingsley is just about the best in the business when it comes to getting those shots through. It's not always a big slapper, but the puck is able to find its way through the legs and right on net.
And we have mutual roughing penalties there. And that means we still have 5-on-5 hockey with 10:15 to go and still just one shot from RMC so far in this period. And I don't think they managed to carry the puck across the red line in a number of minutes. Long shot on now, and that was loose for a second, but ultimately covered up by DeVie.
Yeah, a lot of zone time here for the Ravens, and they continue to throw in pucks up right to the net.
And let me ask you, just referring back to the penalty, Tyler Taylor, is that him just really understanding his role and doing a good job to perhaps get RMC's best player into the penalty box?
That's a great point. I think you're right there. Obviously, Pim's trying to light a fire under his team. Carleton in the past has shown they're not exactly the most disciplined of teams. But if you're Tyler Taylor, that's a fair trade-off.
That's one thing you notice with these Ravens is that they all seem to appreciate their role and sort of play within it as they dump that one in deep. And Brandon McLean will leave it behind the net now for Joey West. Now it's going to be Billingsley who tries to center it in front from a difficult angle. Brad Albert now along the blue line. Not a whole lot of mustard on his shot, and that'll be picked up by RMC. And
they're going to call offside there, and it's going to come all the way down. Should have been an icing call, but either way, the puck will be in the RMC zone.
Yeah, I was ready to call offsides, icing, and a penalty. I wasn't too sure what the...
A little bit of a mix-up there. Airborne puck.
That draws one back to Carleton. That's Stanish now. He'll send it in deep for Porowski. Porowski behind the net from his skate to his stick. He's hammered there. Some battling behind the net as Porowski tries to give his man a what for. More battling in the corner. That's going to be Mike Lowry who picks it up now. The diminutive rookie working with it behind the net. That one's knocked off his stick but onto the tape of Mitchell Porowski. Borowski now trying to generate something. Working out in front as that one is fired just wide. He actually got the look that he was hoping for. Carleton now continuing to apply the pressure. Borowski in the corner now. Working along the half boards. Folks just trying to keep it in onto the stick of Borowski with a look in the slot, but nothing doing as we have a delayed penalty call coming up against RMC as Carleton will get that extra attack run. That's Joey Manley. A shot on. That one's off the skate of Paul Fone as RMC will touch it and get the whistle. But with 8:29 to go in the second period, Carleton is back to the power play.
It's going to be a cross-checking call. It was a dangerous play. Just as the shot was coming, their RMC defender cross-checked the Carleton player to the ice. Might be the best game I've seen of the Carleton centers in the faceoff department tonight. They're winning almost every draw. See if I jinx them here.
You're good, my friend. Let me tell you that. But ultimately kept in by Carleton. That's Matthew Stanish now. He'll feed Joe Placatus. Tries to work out in front with a shot on. Didn't have much of a look there. Not a whole lot of shooting lane to work with. And that one stopped by DeVie. You surprised to see Joey West out there on the power play?
They're giving him more and more looks the past couple games, and He's getting the faceoff back to the defenseman, and that's a pretty good starting point when you're on the power play.
Certainly doing his job, as now it's West indeed. With a nice centering effort, but Joe Placatus couldn't quite handle it. Could have had a good look there on the slot. Now behind the net, that's going to be Ryan McLean for Joey West. To the blue line for Stanish. Down low now. Centering effort. But too hot to handle for Brad Albert, who was streaking in. Joe Placatus now. Leaves it for Albert. Over to Placatus. Tried for perhaps a slap pass there, but it was deflected away, and RMC manages to get it out, and they'll get a change.
It'll be the number one unit. Hayes, Manley, and Porowski coming over the boards for the Ravens.
This is the one you have to watch for if you're RMC. And indeed, there's Lyndon Bain working through the neutral zone with Jeff Hayes now. Hayes tried for the centering pass, but intercepted. Back to the blue line now. That's Joey Manley for Jeff Hayes. Hayes now down low. Oh, and he had Mitchell Porowski, but wasn't quite ready for the pass. Porowski now.
Uh-oh.
Just manages to keep it in ever so narrowly. Centering effort. Once again, Carleton couldn't handle it on the doorstep. Billingsley. His shot is off of Colin Cook, and no chance there as the puck squirts over the glass.
They don't have one on the power play yet tonight, but they sure do look good. You don't see one forward standing still out there while RMC is playing a little too conservative, and Carleton's able to find the passing lanes and shooting lanes and the seams in their box.
Their puck movement is absolutely something to rave about. As they'll try to get one more chance with 18 seconds left on this man advantage. Alex Pym now into the corner. Can't quite get it out as Billingsley pinches and gets it down low. That's Joey West. 8 seconds remaining in the power play. Tim Billingsley finds Stanish. Stanish with a shot on. That one's loose now. As the VA scrambles over to cover up the side of the net, but no shot. And the penalty will expire. We're back to even strength. And now Pinder. Can't quite get around his man in Tim Billingsley. And there's a lot to get around there because he is certainly a big boy.
Just over 6 minutes to go in the period. RMC still with the one shot.
To the blue line for Phone. Paul Phone's shot can't get through. That's going to be Carleton working through the neutral zone. That's Binning. Binning. Can't quite get around his man. Picked up by RMC in their own zone. They'll look to break out. But it's intercepted in the neutral zone by Shane Baker and sent back in. Binning on the forecheck. Applying some pressure, and Carleton will pick it up now. Shane Baker with a nifty little move, but couldn't quite get around his man. Binning now looking to come out in front. A centering effort off the stick of Tyler Taylor, but not quite a shot. Kept in, though. And finally corralled by RMC as Brandon McLean looks to generate something, but it's taken off of his tape. Finally, a long shot in, gloved easily by Ryan Dubé. That'll be their second shot of the period, but not exactly the most challenging. 5 minutes to go here in what's been a relatively quick and relatively uneventful second period. Nice pass there through the neutral zone, but too hot to handle for Vachon, and he couldn't do anything with it. Jordan Deagle now sends that one in deep and just narrowly avoids the hit from Tuan. RMC looking to break out. Just kept in by Folks, and a nice deflection effort in front by Lyndon Bain. That one was loose in the crease after a nice deflection effort. RMC prevails, though, and they'll look to break out. Through the neutral zone. That's going to be Tuan with a shot on, but easily handled by Ryan Dubé. And though they've only had 9 shots, I don't think a single one of those has been really a quality chance, and certainly no rebound opportunities.
I think Ryan and Dubé will agree with you. The defensemen are doing a good job keeping those shots to the perimeter.
That first unit heading back out onto the ice for Carleton, looking to extend this lead with just over 4 minutes remaining in the second period. They can't quite get it out. Finally, they do. Into the RMC zone. Now just nudged over the line. Battling now in the neutral territory. Picked up by Tyler Taylor. He can't get around his man. Now it's going to be Casper who looks to break in. Casper will send it in deep. His teammate gives chase in a centering effort. Nobody there. Flip the line. That's Bouchard. A shot on. That one's wide. Now a That one is picked up by Tyler Taylor, who almost trips there and sent out. Perhaps an expletive coming out of the mouth of Tyler Taylor, as he probably didn't have the shift that they just wanted there, and RMC actually had an opportunity.
They did, and they got tired legs out there for the Ravens now after the icing call.
And the first unit of the Paladins out on the ice, and they'll look to capitalize on some exhausted Ravens.
I am a little surprised the RMC coaching staff has yet to mix up the lines and try and find some better chemistry and energy.
Indeed, they haven't really been able to generate much this evening, and they only have about 23 minutes left to go in this one. Brandon McLean now can't hit his streaking winger as that puck's off the stick of Joey West. Alex Pym now looking to regroup, but there's pressure from Joe Placatus. Placatus hammers him into the boards there.
Ravens were able to escape that situation and get the line change in.
Domenico now coming in all alone with a nifty move, and he scores! That is the goal! We are seeing from the referee that one did eclipse the goal line after a sensational move from Scott Domenico, their leading scorer. That'll be his fifth of the year, and with just under 3 minutes to go, RMC narrows the deficit to one.
It really was a sensational goal. He pulled Dubé one way, and as Dubé tried to reach back the other, there was just a tiny bit of space, and he squeezed the puck and just went over the line.
Ryan Dubé might have even gotten his skate blade on that one, but not enough
there
to.
There certainly wasn't much space there. Great goal.
It really, really was, and that's a big boost for the RMC Paladins, who had been relatively lifeless in the first, 38 minutes of this contest.
It absolutely is. And if you're Marty Johnson and the Ravens, you saw this firsthand, although on the flip side last week in at Concordia, down 2-0. Your goalie kept you in it, but you're able to rally for a 3-2 win. You got to be worried that doesn't happen coming back the other way tonight.
Indeed, it's never the most encouraging to see yourself playing such close games with teams so far down in the standings. Steered aside by Ryan Dubé. And that one centered in front, but Colin O'Rourke couldn't quite handle it. What a chance that would have been. Point blank look as Carleton comes back the other way. Joe Placatus now tries to send it back to the blue line, but that one's over the glass, and we get the goal confirmation.
RMC came back with another strong shift there and did get the puck to the front of the net. Dubé, who plays that butterfly style to a tee, was a bit behind on the play, but the shot wasn't able to reach the net.
And Brandon McLean wins that draw as it's behind the net now for Mike Lowry, who centers, but Shane Baker couldn't quite get his twiggy on it. Picked up now by the goal scorer, Scott Domenico. He sends it around for his defenseman, and now Alex Pym will look to clear it out, but he can't do it. A high stick call now.
He sure does get a lot of ice time there, Alex Pym. The second-year player, they're riding him pretty hard. I thought they were bowling the play for a high stick on the puck, but it's going to be a high-sticking two-minute minor.
Indeed, the sniper himself, Scott Domenico, now will head to the penalty box, and that's really not what you wanted if you're the Paladins right now. You had the momentum after he netted that nifty goal, and now you're going to be down a man for the last 2 minutes of the second period.
And it's been looking more and more like just a matter of time before this power play clicks for a goal.
That's manly. That's going to be Lyndon Boehm with a little bit of room to work. His pass for Joey Manley just squirts over his stick, and that one will clear the zone.
That's the worry with the power play late in the period. The ice is a little choppy, a little rough, and some of those passes are a little too risky to make.
Jeff Ace sends that one in deep. That's going to be Billingsley coming in on the forecheck. He sends it around now. That's back to the blue line for Manley. Manley with a shot on, but that one easily handled. Not too much traffic, just Mitchell Borowski standing in front, but easily gloved by DeVie.
And if no Andrew Glass tonight in the lineup for the Ravens, McLean seeing more and more power play time.
That draw is one back by Carleton as Brad Albert gets it down low. That's Joey West. Center into the slot, but nice job by DeVie to get the paddle down, and we'll get a whistle. And Mike had mentioned that the Ravens are out without Andrew Glass tonight, and that's a real shame because heading into this contest, a four-game point streak for the Wrentham, Massachusetts native. That one is sent down the length of the ice, and on the penalty kill, that's going to be RMC with an aggressive forechecking effort. Carleton breaking out now, 1:02 to go in this one. Ryan McLean now on the near wing. Finds Stanish on the blue line. Stanish with a shot on as that one is deflected wide. Joe Placatus now behind the net. For Joey West, who will get it back out to Brad Albert. For Matthew Stanish on the one-timer. That one is off of the chest of DeVie. Nice save there from the Sackville native. Joe Placatus tries to fire that one on, but that one is well wide. Stanish now on the blue line. 30 seconds to go. Now Joe Placatus, but nice job there to smother the shot by Frederick Touin. They'll send that one down the length of the ice and get a change. 18 seconds to go. One more rush possibly for the Ravens. Jeffrey Hayes working in, slams on the brakes, a nifty little spin move. That one gets down for Lyndon Bain with 6 seconds to go. Battling along the corner, and Carleton will not generate a shot off of that, and the penalty will expire, and after 40 minutes, it's a much closer game than it was 20 minutes ago.
It is indeed a one-goal game. Carleton, you got to be a little worried. You've been taking it to RMC most of the evening, but they're starting to come on here with 20 minutes to go. There's one shot behind.
They absolutely are, and it looks astonishingly similar, perhaps alarmingly similar, to the situation they had last week at Concordia. We'll see how this one plays out. We'll see you back here in 18 minutes. Thank you. Welcome back for the third period of action here at the Carleton University Ice House, where the Ravens are in a game that's perhaps closer than we anticipated, clinging to a 2-1 lead, and frankly, they haven't been able to capitalize on their scoring opportunities so far, particularly with the man advantage.
Yeah, you're bang on there, Jonah. We did comment on how good they looked with their puck movement and shots on net, but in the end, they weren't able to execute on all those power plays in the first and second period. And although it might not have been said that that's the reason in the room, it was definitely something they're all thinking about it. And they're going to have to do things the hard way here in the third period.
Absolutely, and I think one of the reasons for that really can't be overstated is the impressive play of Evan DeVie. Just his first start of the season, but he looks like a seasoned veteran.
Yeah, he definitely does deserve a lot of credit. He came in relief, as we mentioned, in the 7-0 loss last weekend. But he was very comfortable in his first start.
And the intermission clock has expired, but both teams taking an extra second here. And in fact, we have Shane Baker still adjusting his pads, so each respective coach getting one more word of advice into his team.
Sure, the players are just loving that after a nice 16, 17-minute break there.
And one of our linesmen has taken to getting rid of some of that extra water in Ryan Dubé's crease, but of course, the visiting goaltender was left to fend for himself.
Yeah, wet ice, and we saw it at the beginning of the second period. And the puck also has been bounced and taking some funny hops today, and the players have been having a bit of trouble settling it down. Looks like they're just about ready to start. It'll be some 5-on-5 hockey to start the third period.
Indeed. And I'm going to ask you to look into your crystal ball. Which goaltender do you imagine RMC is going to start tomorrow against Ottawa?
That's a good question. All goalies react differently to it, to pregame time off between games, that kind of thing. So I could go either way. I kind of think they're going to go back to their starter.
Yeah, I happen to agree with you. And we're seeing the wet ice right now as Tim Billingsley has the puck get caught up in some moisture, but Carleton will get it in deep. That's Joe Placata sending it in. Ryan McLean now working behind the net, but it's picked up by RMC. Can't get it out, though. That one's kept in by Brad Albert, whose shot couldn't quite reach the net, and was bouncing around there in the slot, but DeVie manages to get his glove on it and cover it up.
Like we talked about, the puck is taking a couple of funny hops and rolling this way and that way. A good job by DeVille to keep his eye on it there.
RMC wins that draw back. And along the far half board, RMC will pick it up and fire it around. That's Pinder now. Can't quite get it out. No deflection effort there from Mitchell Porowski. Off the shot of Brad Albert, but steered aside, and now a long shot in on DeVie. That one was going wide, but he manages to glove it anyways.
It makes you wonder if that's something the Ravens had worked on in practice week, having a big body in front of the net, trying to get sticks on pucks. So they've done a lot of that today. DeVille's been tracking each and every one of them, though.
It's almost as if he's taken to anticipating the deflection. Matthew Stanish now sends it in deep, and that'll be Joey Manley who gets to it first. Tries to send it to Mitch Borowski. Now it's down low and a nifty little move, but Jeff Hayes got tied up and knocked to the ice and couldn't really get much on that shot.
Alex Pym started the period for RMC, took a 30-second shift, went off for 15 seconds, and came right back on. He's doubled over on the side in between whistles as well.
Shane Baker now on the scramble draw. He manages to get that one to his defenseman. Carleton manages to keep it in, and they get it down behind the net. That's Lyndon Boehm who runs into McDonald. But RMC will pick it up, and now a stretch pass for Brandon McLean. Can't quite hit him. But pardon me, that's Alex Pym.
He's everywhere out there.
Knocked into the neutral zone, and RMC will get back onside and actually get a change. That one's intercepted in the neutral zone by Anthony Farrell. He gets that one in deep and takes a hit from Shane Baker as Carleton now looks to break out, but a nice forechecking effort by Vachon. Vachon battling in the corner. He gets it back to Farrell. who can't quite keep it in and loses his stick in the process, but I think his flying stick actually managed to interfere with Shane Baker. Carleton now looking to break in. Folks was in all alone and couldn't quite generate a chance there. As Carleton will regroup. That's Ryan McLean. Gets it in for Joey West. Joey West into the corner. As that one is picked up by Tuen, sent out through the neutral zone and into Carleton territory. It's going to be Charles Correa as RMC gets a change. Up the far wing now for Joe Placatus. Now it's going to be Joey West. As that one bounces over the stick of Ryan McLean as he was heading through the slot. Now in the corner, we have a battle. Ryan McLean is shoved hard into the board, and he scores! Joe Placatus from just outside the faceoff dot fires a slap shot that I don't think Eric DeVie saw, and just like that, Carleton restores the two-goal lead.
An absolute rocket there by Placatus. Very similar to the first goal. The Ravens were able to win a puck battle along the boards and get the puck into the center of the ice, and Placatus had his cannon loaded.
I don't know who was caught more off guard by that goal, Evan DeVie or myself, but nevertheless, Carleton can breathe a little bit easier now with that insurance goal, but still over 17 minutes remaining in this one.
Carleton can attribute this lead to winning those puck battles and those one-on-one battles. Pierre grinded out hockey along the end boards. They've been doing it all game and got two goals out of it so far.
That must feel good for Joe Placatus, who was scoreless in his last four games. Down low, that's Jeff Hayes, who tries to bring it out in front. He's confronted by a number of RMC defenders. Picked up now by Brandon McLean. And the clearing pass effort, unsuccessful, as now Porowski in the slot with a shot on. But that one is easily handled by DeVie.
Immediately following that goal, Carleton switched up their forecheck from the 2-1-2 to sending just one forward in deep. It didn't matter. Hayes was all over that puck down there, and another scoring chance for the Ravens.
That draw is won by Joey West. He's really done an exceptional job in the circle tonight. Now he's got it down low. He looks for a man as he narrowly eludes the hit. Still behind the net. West working with a man on. Mike Lowry looking to provide some assistance as he battles with two Paladins along the half boards. And we'll get a whistle because that puck ain't moving. Joey West wins that draw to Mike Lowry. Now it's in the corner for Binning, who's going to try to move it along. Ultimately picked up by RMC and worked out of the zone. Frederick Tuen takes a hit there, but it was Binning who went flying, and we're going to have a penalty. And it looks like it's going to be Brad Albert.
There's a battle for the puck there. That one could have gone either way, but they got to call Albert. They caught him for a rough.
And this is a big chance for RMC to reduce that deficit to one again. And if they can manage to not one here on the power play, they'll have about 14 minutes to work with, too. That draw is won by Shane Baker. And Carleton gets it down the length of the ice. Off the RMC netminder's paddle, but kept in by Carleton. Long shot from Lyndon Boehm goes wide. Carleton retains possession in the zone, though. Tim Billingsley working in now. That one just fumbles off of his stick. That's going to be picked up now by RMC. That's Pinter. Tries to spring his teammate. Now RMC will look to break in, but it's picked up by Carleton. Kept it nicely by Colin O'Rourke. Now a bouncing puck as a number of players swipe at it, and it's down into the corner. That's going to be Domenico working with some of his teammates and a number of defenders out to the blue line. Pinter sends it to Domenico, and now it's behind the net. Working it into the corner. Carleton can't quite clear their zone. That's Domenico. Sends it back to the blue line for Pinter. And we have an arm up, and we're going to have another penalty coming.
Yeah, they'll have 45 seconds of 5-on-3 action and a real chance to get the momentum back in this hockey game.
Charles Correa will head to the penalty box. And
another roughing call.
Not what you wanted to see if you're Ravens head coach Marty Johnson, as now 45 seconds of a two-man advantage and a good opportunity for RMC as they win the draw. That one's sent to the blue line. Now it's going to be McDonald. McDonald. His shot is blocked by Folks. Reclaims possession. Now sends it across for the captain. That's Pym. Pym with a shot. And he scores! His shot almost certainly deflected out in front. I'm not too sure whose stick it went off, but Ryan Dubé never had a chance in a sensational power play effort from the Paladins, and just like that, we're back to 3-2.
A little bit of noise in this arena, too. A couple Kingston fans have made the trip up the highway for the game. And right there, the Ravens just never really got set up defensively. They didn't set up a triangle, and RMT took full advantage of that. Equipment issue for Ryan Dubé.
And you talk about how pivotal Alex Pym's presence is to this RMC team, and you saw why right there.
Yeah, Alex Pym was a third-round draft pick of the Regina Pats and played parts of three seasons there before coming over to Kingston. And as I mentioned earlier, he played in their junior A system and is in his second season with RMC with the C on the left shoulder.
And as Ryan Dubé is tended to by the equipment manager, Carleton will get a second to catch their breath here. And getting some support via stick banging from their netminder, Evan Devie.
And you after that goal, he was one of the more fired up players on the ice. I glanced down at him. He was celebrating that goal pretty hard. He wants to win this hockey game.
He certainly does, and you can probably notice a bit of a momentum shift in this building.
On RMC, we talked about it. They're a young squad, and sometimes those types of teams are more comfortable playing down a goal. They got nothing to lose, and they're going to come at the Ravens hard.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head there, and it looks like Ryan Dubé is... he's going to head to the bench, actually. Perhaps get a stick replacement, but it also looks like he's tinkering with his pads there. Perhaps his skate.
We'll see if the referees allow this. Or, no, they're going to have to send in Francis Dupuis.
Well, and just like that, Francis Dupuis, who hasn't played since November 9th, he's going to get an opportunity to go in there and preserve the lead for Carleton.
A tough situation to be thrown into. He's coming in cold here with 14 minutes to go in the third period. The former CJHL star and RBC Cup winner with the Pembroke Lumber Kings has only started one home game in the season.
Yeah, and he wanted to get a stretch in there, but yeah, the referee wasting no time directing him to the net. Do not pass go. Do not collect $200. But fortunately, he got the support of the crowd. They were showing him the love with a nice round of applause. And let's remember that once again, RMC is still working with a man advantage for a minute and 37 seconds.
They really do have a golden opportunity here with a nice cold goalie.
Bringing in is Alex Pym. He'll drop for Brandon McLean. McLean shakes his defender. Tries to center that one in front, but it's off a skate and out of harm's way. McDonald keeps it in. He'll send it down low as four players converge. Brandon McLean hits the deck.
Careful.
But he emerges with it. And now an open look at the slot, and a shot on. That one's just wide from Alex Bim, who had a glorious look. Now it's going to be a foot race. Shane Baker coming hard onto the puck, but RMC manages to pick it up. Or do they? Nice little forecheck effort there, and Carleton bats it into the RMC zone, but the Paladins pick it up. 52 seconds remaining on the power play. They get that one in deep and negate the icing call with a little deflection. Tim Billingsley hits Jeffrey Hayes, who will get it down the length of the ice. That one is sent over the glass as O'Rourke took a hard hit there from Brad Albert and gave him a little bit of stick there to show his appreciation.
This really is an opportunity. RMC's got a relish, but they have yet to throw a shot and test out Dupuis.
28 seconds remaining in the power play. That one is won by Carleton, but eludes the defender. So RMC will set up. 15 seconds to go in this man advantage. That's down deep in the corner. Picked up by RMC. That's Domenico. He already has one tonight. He's got a little bit of space. Back to the blue line for Colin O'Rourke. He'll wait. The penalty has expired. We're back to even strength now as he tries to send that one in front. And that one is just missed by Domenico, who could have had an open look from point blank range.
Stick on the ice and he has an open look.
And now a wraparound effort, but not a whole lot on it. And Francis Dupuis does a good job to get over there and take away the shot as we've got a little bit of extracurriculars going on in front. And Francis Dupuis has done his job. He'll get a nice little round of applause. And Ryan Dubé is back. And Francis Dupuis getting gestures of gratitude from his teammates via pats on the head, who did a good job to come in and stand pat for a couple of minutes there as Ryan Dubé was tended to.
He did what he had to do.
That draw is won by the Paladins. And that one, oh, is intercepted by Folks, who does a good job to catch it. But it's shot back into the Carleton zone. That's Folks again. Just under 12 minutes to go in this one. And we're going to have a high stick call.
High stick on the Ravens. Face off to the right of Dubé. Domenico, McLean, and Pinder being relied on heavily down the stretch for RMC.
Through the neutral zone, that's Jeff Hayes, who leaves it for Manley. Manley coming in with a shot on. Good job there by DeVa to come out and cut off the angle. Domenico now working out of his own zone. He can't quite find his teammate Pinder. Carleton now looking to break in. That's Jeffrey Hayes. Working down low as he's hammered into the boards there. McLean, the one who provided the hit. Now it's behind the RMC net as Pinder will pick it up and leave for Alex Bim.
Hayes is one of those players that could get away without a name bar in the back of the jersey. You know when the puck's on his stick.
Matthew Stanish now manages to shake one man, and he'll bring it over the blue line. From an odd angle, fires that one just wide. And that one will squirt out of the zone, fired back in by Tim Billingsley. Joey West first in on the forecheck. But a nice long pass there as RMC tries to do something with it, coming through the neutral zone. But it's picked up by Carleton. Joey West, in fact. Centers in front now! And that was, I believe, Joe Placatus, who just got his stick on it. But a nice job there by DeVa to take away a chance. Now it's Tim Billingsley. for Placatus, who will deflect it in and get a change. Down low now. Aggressive forecheck by the Ravens. Shane Baker absolutely levels his man, leaves his feet, and we are certainly going to see a penalty. And a delayed one, in fact, as there's a shot on. And Brad Albert hammers his man as we have an exchange of physical action. And, oh, my goodness, it looks like the recipient of that Shane Baker hit, not only did he lose his helmet, he might be seeing stars. He looks a little bit dazed and confused.
He does. Little Bambi legs there. Baker's night's done. He's getting 2-10 for hit to the head.
Yeah, there's no doubt there that he targeted the head, and in my estimation, he left his feet as well.
Yeah, it's tough to fault the guy when he's that much taller than the opponent.
And as Joey Manley, who has the A on his jersey, asks for clarification, looks like the Paladins will get a nice little breather. And
while we have a second, you mentioned Joey Manley at the A. Are you surprised the Ravens have not strapped a C on anyone's jersey yet this season?
I am. They have a number of well-seasoned veterans who are more than deserving, and guys who come out on a nightly basis and provide offense or do what they have to do, as now shouts of displeasure rain down on the ice as Shane Baker is sent home early from this one. But yes, back to your question, Mike, I am a little bit surprised, and yeah, I figured that they might have opted to go with Ryan Berard or Joey Manley or Jeff Hayes. Hayes, in fact, was the former Oshawa Generals captain, so it is a tad perplexing.
As am I, and as long as you have more than one great leader on your team, I guess you can't really blame them.
Yeah, a lot of capable leaders on this Carleton squad. And speaking of captains, there's Alex Pym, who is going to anchor the blue line for this power play, along with Scott McDonald. In fact, we have a four-minute double minor as Carleton wins that draw, but can't get it out. Finally, they do, as Alex Pym chips it over on the back end to Scott McDonald, and they'll look to break in now. Delayed offside. Very, very close call, but our linesman signaled that he was, in fact, ahead of the play, and we'll get a whistle.
You mentioned it was a four-minute call. We haven't got the official word at the in-house announcer here, but you got to think he got 2 minutes for hit to the head, the 10-minute misconduct that comes along with that, and two more for unsportsmanlike. He did have a couple words to say to the referee on his way out. We will wait for the official announcement, though.
Indeed, and that'll prove to be a pretty decent opportunity for RMC to tie this one up, and here we go. Well, Mike absolutely nailed it on the head there. So Baker's night is done, as we've mentioned, and RMC with 3 minutes and 16 seconds to go as Alex Pym will chip it in deep and take a hard hit there from Brad Albert.
The Ravens sure are targeting him, but the kid doesn't go down.
Now that's going to be Hayes now. Tries for the behind-the-back center on a nice shorthanded opportunity, but he couldn't quite hit Joey West. As we have a 3-on-2 now, that's going to be Vachon. Vachon tries to hit McLean. That one was just bouncing around in the offensive zone, but now we have another whistle.
Did they catch the Ravens with too many men? Doesn't look like it.
Not too sure what the source of that whistle was, and in fact, oh no, Ryan
McLean. The Ravens
McLean
look like they feel they're guilty of too many men. No, it is going to be too many men.
Well, things just going from bad to worse for the Carleton Ravens, as now they're going to be down 2 men for a full 2 minutes.
Full 2 minutes. RMC made short work of that last 5-on-3.
That's Pinder now. Oh, nice diving effort there from Folks, but he can't quite get it out. Oh, it's kept in now. Oh, and that could have been a nice open look for O'Rourke coming through the slot, but it just bounced off of his tape, and they will have to regroup. Pinder gets it in deep, and Ryan Dubé will come out to play it. Back to the blue line for O'Rourke. Pinder again. That one is caught up in the skates and ultimately corralled by RMC. Domenico to the side and a shot on. That one is steered aside by Dubé.
Ravens have changed two of their three defenders. Stanich is still caught out there. He'll get off the ice now.
Yeah, they managed to get that one down the length of the ice, and RMC with 55 seconds to go on this two-man advantage. They'll get a change as well. That's Alex Pym bringing it through the neutral zone, or rather leaving it for his teammate McDonald. McDonald gets it in deep, and he'll chase it himself. Sent around now as Cook will pinch. McDonald along to Pym. Pym trying to set something up. With a shot on, he scores! Serenity now! Pym with an absolute rocket from just inside the blue line. Ryan Dubé didn't even see that one as it soared right over his glove, and just like that, it is a tied hockey game.
Deja vu on that goal. Pym from the exact same spot. You would have thought Dubé would have caught on and came out and challenged that a bit more, but he's caught deep in his net, and Pym beat him over the glove hand.
Just a sensational goal, and Alex Pym with his second key contribution, and his second key contribution coming with a man advantage.
We talked about it coming into the third. The Ravens weren't able to take advantage of their power plays, and RMC has done the exact opposite, tying the game up here in the third period.
And still a minute 15 to go in that too many men on the ice penalty, as RMC will look to take their first lead of the game. That one is kept in the Carleton zone and finally picked up by Hayes and sent out. Now it's Tim Billingsley working down low. Sends that one through the crease, but nobody was there. Matthew Stanish now hits Jeff Hayes. Hayes now with a little bit of room, but not a whole lot of reinforcements. Working from the far wing, tries to center in front, but Ryan McLean couldn't get a shot off. Now we have a 2-on-2. Make that a 3-on-2. It's Domenico. Domenico with lots of room coming in. And I couldn't quite get a shot on net.
He had a shooting lane.
That one's picked up by Lyndon Babe. Babe coming in all alone with a nifty little move, but he couldn't quite get his stick on it. No penalty call. He might have been disrupted there by the RMC defender, but Lyndon Babe couldn't quite get past his man. It's now a huge hit from Matthew Stanish.
The Ravens aren't going to roll over. I think you're right. I think he did get disrupted by a stick, and I was looking to center ice for a penalty shot there. It looked like he hooked him right in the glove at the last second. But if you get away with it, it's a great play.
Down low, that's Scott Domenico, who blows a tire and goes hard into the boards. Now at the blue line, it's Pinder. That one is chipped out by Joey Manley. Joey Manley with a 2-on-1. He's coming in now with speed. Sends for Joe Plekanis, who scores! He scores! Joe Plekanis, after a sensational effort by Joey Manley, he sends it to the crease, and Plekanis, with those soft, soft hands, puts it in and restores the lead for Carleton.
That's the hat trick for Plekanis, as you mentioned. What a play by Manley, though, to settle that puck down. It was rolling on him. Everyone was looking at him to shoot the puck with that fantastic release he has, but he slid it over to Plekanis, who drove the far post and just tapped it in.
The Carleton crowd absolutely erupting after that one, and considering the way this period had been trending, that is huge for the Carleton Ravens.
Massive, 5:36 to go.
That one is played by DeVie, as I am likely drowned out by the sound of the very appreciative crowd. Folks now spins away from his man and sends that one in deep. Played by DeVie, as Plekanis hammers his man there in the corner. I believe that was Filiatrol. Now looking to break out, that's RMC. Sends it through the neutral zone, but Brandon McLean can't quite corral it. Now it's Joey West with an ill-timed change from RMC. Now it's shot for Joey Manley. Joey Manley trying to work through the slot. He couldn't quite generate a chance. Now it's worked into the corner as Brandon McLean looks to break out. He'll just send that one in deep, and his teammates will give chase as he gets a change. Brad Auer picks it up. 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this one. Billingsley off the glass. Can't quite get it out, but we'll have a high stick call. And with time winding down in this one, Carleton will send out Tyler Taylor to perhaps get physical and serve to intimidate this top unit from the Paladins.
Yeah, and he's out there against the first unit, as you mentioned, of the Paladins.
That one's sent down in deep as McDonald with a man on. That's Mitchell Porowski, and he also takes a hit there from Taylor, but RMC will pick up the puck and look to break out. Sends that one in deep, but no icing call, and that one's sent on, and he goes hard into the net, knocks it off his moorings, crashes into Ryan Dubé, and
he crashed into him pretty hard there. Good to see Dubé back up on his feet right away.
No worse for the wear.
See if they bring the faceoff outside or if they're going to call the Carleton player. That looks like it will be the call. They're going to call the Carleton player on pushing him into the goaltender.
The referee is restoring the net onto its moorings as we have just over 4 minutes to go in this one. That draws one back to Bouchard. Oh, nice effort there by Binning, who manages to tip it out of his reach. Dubé out to play. It'll leave for Albert. Albert now taking his time. Leaves it for Manley. Manley for Bame. Aggressive play there by Duvier to come out and play the puck. Carleton will send that one in, and the defense will get a change. Picked up now by Bouchard. All intercepted there on a nice forecheck by Lyndon Bame. Lyndon Bame still working with it. He'll try to send it down low or at least leave for Binning, but nothing doing. Now it's going to be Filiatro bringing it out. And Vachon gets it in deep and takes a hit there for his efforts. Picked up by Ryan McLean now as he dances around Alex Pym. But can't quite get past Brandon McLean, who will send it around now for Domenico. Joey West tries to center, but that one is picked up by Alex Pym just in front of the netminder. And RMC does manage to get it out, but again, it's picked up by Carleton in the neutral zone. They'll send it back in deep. 2:40 to go in this one as DeVille will play it.
Great job by the Ravens here as time's winding down. They keep the puck 200 feet from their own net. Taylor back out there for another late third period shift.
Yeah, he may not have seen a whole lot of minutes, but he's seeing a lot of important minutes this
Absolutely.
Evening.
Absolutely. Nothing wrong with that.
Now Pinder looking to apply some pressure as Carleton breaks out. That's Jeff Hayes now on the near wing. Can't quite chip it past his man. Carleton will retain possession, and Billingsley will wait and slap it in. Jeff Hayes giving chase. Just under 2 minutes to go now. Mitchell Porowski working down low. He's stood up there by Colin Cook. Jeff Hayes working behind the net. Sent back down low by Billingsley, but picked up by RMC. Minute 39 left. Sends that one out down deep, but only onto black jersey territory. And now it's Carleton breaking in. Mitchell Porowski with an open look and a nice glove save by DeVille to keep his team in the game with a minute 27 to go.
I'm really surprised RMC is not upping the ante here and getting two players in on the forecheck and in on the puck battles, even in their own zone. They only got a minute 27 left here to get a goal.
They're certainly going to need to win this faceoff and march down the ice. And
timeout, RMC.
Yeah, they'll opt to catch their breath and perhaps cook up a strategy here with time winding down.
As you mentioned, it's going to start with winning the faceoff. Faceoffs have been in favor of the Ravens all night, but if they can win this big one here, it'll go a long way.
Indeed, and this one's certainly far from over, but with a little stoppage in play, Mike, who would you say is RMC's player of the game this evening?
Great effort by the netminder tonight. He's really kept them in the game, and he's faced 32 shots, but I got to go with Alex Pym. The kid's played huge minutes. He's been all over the ice, and he's got those two huge third-period goals for them tonight.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more, and then we'll throw it back to you again. How about Carleton?
You got to go with Bocanus. The hat trick tonight, really, really hopefully a turning point in his season, and he can catch fire.
Yeah, he had been struggling offensively for the past few games heading into this one, but this will certainly recharge his batteries with a three-goal effort here tonight. And
most
the timeout
definitely.
Is just about done, and naturally the first unit from RMC coming out as Carleton manages to keep the puck in the zone off the draw. Joe Placatus working hard behind the net as he gets into a tussle there. And now it's a shot and he scores! Joey Manley on a fantastic centering effort from Joey West when RMC just couldn't get the puck out of their zone, and that'll effectively seal their fate. Just a minute 16 to go and Carleton with a 5-3 lead.
What a great goal. Joey to Joey. West sets up his second goal of the period. And Manley, after making a beautiful setup on the last goal, really deserved that one.
Well, we talked about how important Joey Manley's presence in this Carleton lineup has been for the Ravens. And
two more points tonight.
Yeah, we were certainly vindicated here this evening as Carleton takes a two-goal lead with just 75 seconds left to go in this one. RMC will win that draw and look to break in. Folks down low, can't quite hit his teammate. And RMC will battle centered in front, but no shot there. Lowry is knocked to the ice by Thuin as he tried to break in. And with 54 to go, RMC will look to get the puck into Carleton territory. Ryan McLean will just send that one in nice and softly and give his forwards time to get a change going. And down low now, it's the third period specialist Tyler Taylor going to work. Jordan Deagle will keep that one in. 27 seconds to go now. Back to the blue line for Taylor. Taylor winds and fires. But that one is smothered by DeVille, and we have 20.9 seconds to go in this one.
Great effort by RMC, especially in the final 20 minutes. Unfortunately, they did not get the start they wanted to, and that was the difference tonight.
Certainly was, and this game definitely a microcosm for their season at large. Only managed 17 shots on net, and it's really difficult to score, especially against a goaltender as fundamentally sound as Ryan Dubé when you're only putting up 17 shots.
Right, Gerard. You got Ottawa U tomorrow, and what you want to do is take the game plan Carleton threw at you and throw that game plan at Ottawa U.
Absolutely, and they'll just wait that one out, and the horn will make it official as the fans rise to their feet, and the unofficial anthem, "The Bird is the Word," begins to serenade down to the ice. Carleton will take this one 5-3 and extend their winning streak to four games. What is important that they do tomorrow against Queen?
Tomorrow they gotta come out the same way they came out today. They really pushed their pace in the first period. Starts have been a forte on this team all year, and if they can do that against Queens, it's a team that they're in a battle with in the standings, they'll have a good afternoon.
Absolutely, and they'll look to extend their winning streak to five games tomorrow against Queens University. And with that, it's been a pleasure. I'm Jonah Birnbaum. Alongside me, yeah, he's a rookie, but you wouldn't know from that performance tonight, Mike James, signing off from the Carleton University Ice House. Thanks for tuning in.